Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Music and Science. I'm Stefan. In this video I would like to give you some scientific background information about the question why the sun plays cool music. There are two parts. The first part is this video, and there's a second part in another video. Below you can see a video description, and on the upper right there are sometimes information cards appearing.
I would like to show you the connection between old violin wood and climate. And for this explanation, I would like to go back. Violins are made of wood, of course. And I show you an example how it looks like. So if you go more closer, if you cut a tree, you can see, for example, these details. Have a look. These are the so-called, if you can see it, so-called tree rings, or so-called annual rings, and each ring corresponding to 1 year. There is a general rule, or general what you can remember. Broad rings means good climate or warm, and thin rings, close together, and that means in general bad climate or cold. However, the grow is also influenced by environmental factors and position, of course. On this larger piece of wood, you can see it more clearly. You can see the rings with broad rings, and here at the end, yes, more thinner rings, and each rings corresponding to the growth of 1 year. And as you say already, that's depending on the climate and the environmental factors plays a role, and the position of the wood, of course. If you go a bit more closer, you can see that the color is a bit changing.
Now we take a closer look at the anneal rings. This hand drawing shows a transverse section of a bough of a tree, especially a pine. For your orientation, here on the left panel, you can see showing the section of the previous image, showing some anneal rings. And here on the right part, you can see one anneal ring, and you can see single cells, early wood and the late wood here. And for the orientation, this direction is to the bark, and this direction is to the marrow, to the center of the bough. You can see some structures, especially here is, for example, a resin channel. And inside the channel is there are very small resin drops. And the surrounding cells, the specific type of cells, for example, gland epithelial cells. The next slide shows a transversal section of a seed bearing plant. And here is the plant, part of the plant. Here is the root, and here is the shoot is here. And here the next here lower part shows a cut transverse section here. It's looked like that. A specific cut type of cells, as you can see here. And here some these dots are vascular bundles. Here in higher magnification, you see the details. And the next slide shows a cut somewhere here, and it's look like here. You can see again structure, and again these vascular bundles showing here in the higher magnification. Next slide shows a transversal section of a leaf of the same plant. You can see the upper part, the upper epidermis, for example. Here the lower epidermis, the lower part. The lower part, this location is the interesting location regarding the carbon dioxide. The plants are breathing in the carbon dioxide somewhere here where the stroma is. Okay, coming back to the carbon dioxide issue.
During the grow, a plant needs CO2 from the air. However, there are two different variants of carbon. It's 12 CO2 and 13 CO2.
This figure shows two different types of isotopes of carbon. Here on the left, you can see carbon 12, here the atomic nuclei. And as you know, carbon has 6 protons and 6 electrons. The protons are shown here in dark blue. And an isotope has, carbon 12 isotope has additional 6 neutrons, as shown here in red. And the same is for the carbon 13, but there's an additional neutron on here. 7 neutrons are here, and then we have carbon 13. And in the atmosphere, the last 10,000 years, it was the ratio between carbon 12, carbon dioxide, and carbon 13, CO2, was nearly constant. We have a high amount of carbon 12, CO2, 98.9%, and only we have 1.1% carbon 13 CO2 in the atmosphere.
If plants feel well at sufficient temperature and enough rain, stroma is widely open, and mainly the 12 carbon CO2 will be stored in the wood.
Here again, a transverse section of a leaf is shown. Here the leaf, the whole leaf. Upper epidermis is shown here. Lower epidermis is shown here. And here you can see the stroma, some a leak in the lower side of the leaf. And as you remember, we have more carbon 12 carbon dioxide in the air than carbon 13 CO2. And consequently, the plant have transport from carbon 12 CO2, more carbon 12 CO2 into the leaf than carbon 13, as shown here. And the process is as follows. The carbon dioxide is transformed into glucose by using a specific enzyme, and then finally it will produce the wood at the end. If the weather is fine, we have a regular process with a lot of glucose and a lot of wood, and therefore the rings are broader. They have a complete different situation if the weather is, which is shown here. We have less glucose, and at the end we have smaller amount of wood and thinner rings. And the difference is that you can see is that there is a limitation or somehow inhibitory effect of the stoma because of bad weather. And then there's a shift from carbon 12 to carbon 13 carbon dioxide. That means there's a shift. And this is an interesting phenomenon which can be used for further investigation.
Exactly these small changes in the composition of the carbon led to recognize change of climate. I give you an example with a violin. This is a violin explaining or demonstrating the effect, the change of climate. You can see more broader rings on this part of the violin, and here on the other part, here you can maybe see the annual rings are more thin, or thinner rings, as you can see here. It means that very likely there's a temperature range here from the warm to more colder years that demonstrate the change of the weather between. You can count these rings, of course, and you can count the years, and the years, every year, the temperature was decreasing in this interesting part.
Thank you for viewing this video. Here I would like to summarize what I have talked about, why the sun plays cool music. In the beginning, I showed you some examples of tree rings, also known as grown rings, also named as annual rings. And then I showed you a microscopic image, which was hand-drawn, showing one single annual ring and some other structures here seen on this hand-drawn image. Furthermore, I explained you the isotopes of carbon, especially carbon 12 carbon dioxide and carbon 13 carbon dioxide. And then the next point I tried to explain it very simplified, the process from CO2 to glucose and finally to wood, and that is dependent on the weather and the climate. Finally, I showed you an example of a violin and the rings, annual rings on a violin. I recommend you to view the second part of this video, focusing more on the role of the sun and the climate during the last 400 years. Thank you for viewing this video.